shooting guard, number 20, Breon January. The other guard, number 5, Jasmine Thomas. Starting at center, number 42, Brianna Jones. At the small forward position, number 24, Delwanna Bonner. Starting at the other forward position, number 35, Jonquel Jones.
Outside. Here's Jones. Off to a good start. Hits her first shot.
Takes great angles when crashing the glass. Jones has mastered the art of rebounding.
Outside quickly. That's good. And so 14 man Sloop gets the assist.
But for the defense, they've got to talk to each other. Clearly in air, not getting out there on a three-point attempt.
Here's Bonner. Another shot. Goes up with it again. That one doesn't drop, so Chicago will take it the other way.
And now they're 1-for-5 to start this game, having trouble getting it going.
Pass to Parker. Quigley. And again, Chicago with a three.
Talk about reading the floor. Parker's teammates feed off her energy as a playmaker. You just have to appreciate Candace Parker's athleticism. The effort level she plays at is marvelous. And you see it on both ends of the floor.
Now here's Vandersloot. To the inside. Stolen by Jones. And it's Courtney Vandersloot with the rebound. And what I like most about Parker's physical abilities is how she uses them to make big statement plays.
Yeah, I mean, we have seen Candace dunk. Only the second ever player to do it for the WNBA game. She is just a unique, incredible talent. Such a well-rounded offensive player. She's got a little bit of everything.
Outside quickly.
To make crisp, precise passes to her open teammates.
Quigley, good.
Yes, Courtney Vandersloot.
And here's Thomas. Inside, here's January. That's her second shot and her second basket. My math says that's 2-for-2. Chicago trailing here. Now Vandersloot, pass to Copper. From downtown, she's now 1-for-2 in that bucket.
3 points.
If you like Copper to get comfy, get time, and get set, she'll just continue to bury these shots.
Good. That's the 10th straight point they've given up.
It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is. If they keep allowing outside.
Now here's Vandersloot. Lets the three fly. Here's Dolson. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Another reason you want Dolson on your team. She can turn a missed basket into points. Tremendous effort on the boards.
It's good on the front back.
Not much resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic. In fact, I'll just say it, they are automatic.
Out to Vandersloot. The three is up. No good on that shot. And Connecticut will come the other way. To the middle. Back to Bonner. Off target with the three.
Their shooting numbers slipping this quarter.
Pass to Vandersloot. Back to Parker. And here's Copper. Here's Quigley. Covered by January. Allie Quigley is doubled. Vandersloot. Just five on the clock. The shot. No good. January right side. Jones. Got her with the pump fake. Just couldn't finish. 8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Dolson, guarded by Jones. Pass to Vandersloot from deep. Courtney Vandersloot with another miss. In transition, here comes the Sun. Gunwell Jones with room to shoot. And she gets that one to go off the front line.
He picks up on opponents' tendencies and will make them pay. January has a refined feel for the game.
Now Copper. Back to Vandersloot. Let's go with a three. And no good trying to get that one. Plenty of offense in this closely contested first quarter of play. The Sun on top, up three. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. And it's been a tight one here as the second quarter getting going. And guys, what's your take on the Sun so far?
There hasn't been a lot of settling for outside shots really early on.
Yeah, they've done a good job to work it low and not take the easy way out on offense. No shortcuts.
Pound it low.
Chicago with the ball. It's a three-point game. Quigley gets the bucket.
Showing off her NBA level range and then some. Quigley, night in and night out, puts pressure on that defense.
Chicago
you have to be impressed by Allie Quigley's accuracy. She's got her long-range shooting totally dialed in and is one of the league's most consistent three-point snipers.
Here's Heidemann. Back to Jones. And stolen by Courtney Vandersloot.
She took advantage of the tight space inside and made the beautiful steal.
Pass to Parker, back to Vandersloot. From deep three-point range, that's good, and it's Candace Parker with the assist.
Well, who could forget the two-year streak where Quigley dominated the All-Star three-point contest?
Back-to-back champion, you certainly don't see that often. It's a real testament to Quigley's talent as a long-range shooter, arguably the best in the world.
Now here's the Shields, back to Vandersloot. The Shields. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over again.
They might have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their ninth straight point from beyond the arc.
First personal foul, team's first. Second team foul.
Here's Heidemann.
On both ends, Vandersloot works hard to make an impact. She gives her all to shut the shooter down.
It's stolen by Jonquel Jones. Now here's January. Vandersloot defending. And so she has a trip to the line. Stephanie saw the contact. And it's 2-2. All right, let's get some love to players that might get overlooked. Who's the best role player?
They might not score a ton, but Brianna Turner does everything else. Turner racks up rebounds. She's an all-defensive team member, and she's just a flat-out winner.
I think of role players are those who might not put up huge scoring totals, but have a huge impact on games. Jaleesha Clark is my pick. She's been a key on multiple title teams, a defensive ace, the type of player every coach wants on their squad.
Now, here's Parker. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game. There's the triple. No good. And Connecticut will go the other way with it.
They're trying to shoot her way out of it. They have the lead. She might help by being a little bit more selective.
And that one's good.
They're finding lanes to hoop every time down. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Or at least some fight.
Timeout called the sky.
After foregoing the 2020 WNBA season due to coronavirus concerns, Jonquel Jones came back better than ever in 2021.
And so it's Chicago with it. Outside to Shields. Watch it. Vandersloot. It's good. The assist that time from Diamond and Shields.
That's a dozen straight points coming off of threes.
Yeah, they're having free reign from beyond the arc. The defense is, I'm going to go out on a limb and say, non-existent.
Some fancy ball skills right there. Since when does she take defenders off the dribble like that?
Jones not only played at an MVP level in the WNBA, but also took her country of Bosnia and Herzegovina to new heights.
Yeah, it doesn't matter who or where she's playing. Jones is a star. She can do it all on the court, but at her size, I mean, it is just almost unfair.
Now here's Vandersloot. 8 points for her. The Shields. Bonner to the first half. Sinks the three-pointer.
As hot as she's been this quarter, the game plan should be simple. Get her the ball and get out of the way.
And stolen by Courtney Vandersloot. Good for another field goal. Number five on the night. 5-for-10 shooting.
They really turned it around here in the second quarter after shooting less than 40% from the field in the first.
Here's Huddleman. Lays it up and makes it in.
They're not rotating quickly enough on defense down low.
They've got to provide more resistance inside.
Outside to Shields. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five buckets are from three-point range.
The defense, they have to close out quicker.
Here's Jones. Add another one. Scoring all over her. He's 7-for-10 from the field.
The combination of 6'6 size and touch with Jonquel Jones, it's special. It's almost one of a kind. And you'd like to see her score inside even more.
Nice shot by DeShields.
Great outside shooting is really fueling this run.
And the D's just getting bombarded. They haven't been able to slow them down.
The kick out to Bonner. And right away, everything faster with a three-pointer of their own.
From beyond the arc, DeWanna Bonner can be very consistent. She makes those long-range shots look easier than they appear.
Now here's Quigley. He's got a lot of people. Bangs home the trifecta.
Well, they're getting their points now almost exclusively from three-point range. For the last five makes from beyond the arc.
And the defense practically giving them the shots.
And they'll take it.
So it's both teams making
now
substitutions
the
here.
Chicago.
Here's January. She has six. Thomas outside. Jones. That falls.
An efficient offensive player. The most impressive thing about Jones to me is she is capable of huge nights without wasting a lot of possessions.
He gets it in there.
She has been unconscious this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Look, that's the risk you run by staying out of there. She picks up personal foul of the game.
Her first trip to the line.
A much improved free throw shooter. Thomas is always looking to get better.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
In the second quarter, they had the right approach. Driving, drawing contact, and creating opportunities at the line.
Well, when all else fails, getting to the charity stripe can really be a great way to change the momentum in a game.
Let you regroup, stops the clock.
Rion January from a long range.
He can't hit that guy.
Well, you can see it in her eyes. She wanted to return the favor with that three, but she just couldn't get it to go.
And we've reached halftime in this one. It's the Sky. They're up by 11. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
Tenacity defensively. Her play on defense has been a big factor for them as she comes away with steal after steal.
And as the game moves on, I think she should continue to be aggressive on the defensive end and really just keep ball handlers off balance.
Welcome back to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the final two quarters.
Outside Quigley. Back to Vandersloot. Pass to Coffer.
Three-pointer.
Dan Jones pulls it down. The Sun on offense. They trail by 11.
Well, in the 2020 bubble, Kalia Coffer became one of the league's most improved players, averaging 15 points per game, which is more than double her previous career.
Chopped up.
Creating high percentage looks from close range.
And even under pressure and tight, they've maintained their concentration and converted their opportunities.
And for Copper, that production carried over to the 2021 season as she was named to her first WNBA All-Star.
A pretty incredible to have that jump in production. It's just really not something you see happen too often. The player's sixth season in the league. But it's just great to see Copper thrive individually and as a teammate and continue to grow her game.
Now here's Thomas. Here's Bonner. Goes up from the top of the key. No good off the back of the rim.
She had all the space she needed but just could not find the bottom of the bucket.
Pass to Quigley. Vandersloot. She's covered by Thomas.
Here's Quigley. Shoots over January. And there is the Sky with another bucket.
Well, you gotta like her shot selection today. She set the bar for the rest of the team.
Now here's Thomas. Vandersloot defending. Jones misses.
It's very dangerous to leave her open like that. Lucky break for the D that she missed it.
Pass to Quigley. Copper.
She has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys, but as a whole, it really hasn't affected the team that much.
Well, we all want to see expansion in the league, and so when we do, what cities do you think are prime candidates?
I'm a Bay Area guy, so I have to mention San Francisco or Oakland. The Warriors have a great fan base. They love women's hoops in this area.
Zero arguments for me about getting a team to the Bay. But I'm going north of the border. I'm going with Toronto, a team that the entire country of Canada can get behind. But then really, guys, no wrong answers. There are so many options. And I'm just excited to see where the WNBA goes next.
Now here's Quigley. Pass to Vandersloot. Over to the wing. Here's Copper. It's
wash out. Now that she's got her first three of the half, there might be more in store.
Connecticut trailing.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
Now here's Thomas. Bonner outside. Down low, Jones. That's good.
Unselfish player. Bonner is one of the best passing forwards in the WNBA, constantly looking to get everybody involved.
Copper, no good.
Her strokes look a little shaky this quarter. Not much is hitting the target.
Thomas with the ball. Vandersloot covering.
Soft touch on the glass. Was not saved at all by the bigger defender on her. And in the low block, I thought she might be a little fake.
Yeah, you wouldn't think that would be her comfort zone, but hey, she looked pretty comfortable right there, didn't she?
Chopper, no good.
She's been eye full to 3-point range since halftime, and she continues to fire away. She's got to tone it down.
Thomas has steadily honed in on her craft and really has become this incredible player that you see today.
Here's Copper. She's got an eye. Back to Vandersloot. Copper. Pass to Vandersloot. The three. It is good. And it is a 6-make against 11 attempts.
Can they make some sort of defensive adjustment? Because guess what? She is killing them.
And even when they have closed out on her, she's still knocking them down. I mean, this is just an unbelievable performance we're seeing right now.
Bonner with it. Now here's Jones. And she drops in the layup off the three.
They're not using the three-point shot very much. They may want to think about stretching the defense a bit like they did in the first half.
Outside to Shields. Good on the three-point shot.
Well, you love to see that offensive mindset from DeShields. And really, she's showing that she is not afraid to extend her range.
Sky foul.
First trip to the free throw line for her.
Second to
the first free throw is good.
Shooting for goal, Connecticut Sun.
And good on the second. So she makes both.
With multiple Six Woman of the Year awards, Bonner is without a doubt one of the best teammates in WNBA history.
For three. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
And they are just killing them with the three-point shot here in the second half.
Yeah, and the defense knows it. They're fully stretched out there trying to stop the three and still haven't been able to do it.
Adam knows defensively what they could do different at this point. They're looking bounce back instead of the basket.
And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Sky out in front. They're up by 11. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. And now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
This was an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for her.
Yeah, she served her up some tasty room service right there, guys. Sweet dime.
Welcome back. Fourth quarter of action starting up in what has been a one-side show. Up top, Bonner. She's guarded by Stevens. Rejected by Diamond DeShields.
Outstanding awareness from DeShields. You can see she enjoyed that rejection.
Endor. And two shots coming up at the line. Shoot gets fouled on the shot. And there's the foul. Gets Connecticut. And she knocks down the first one. She hits both from the stripe.
In the shortened 2020 season, Diamond DeShields was hampered by injuries, only appearing in 13 games, and was unable to get back to full strength.
It's Stephanie Dolson, high post. And here's Heidemann.
Chicago foul. Second personal foul. First team foul. Now into the lineup for Chicago, Candace Parker.
And the foul.
foul called on Courtney Vandercourt. That's her fifth foul.
And by the start of the 2021 season, the Shields had recovered from her injuries and was back to being a leading scorer.
Yeah, and while she's seen as a scorer, the Shields does so much more on the court to really pass the rebound.
Vandersloot with it. Pass to the Shields. Outside Quigley. Back to the Shields. Vandersloot from deep. It's rebounded by Thomas. Here's Connor. Down to the hoop and goes. That's her fifth bank on nine shots.
She's come out here in the second half and done a great job of finding her range.
Now here's the Shields. And out of bounds, the Sun will take it. Connecticut Sun ball. There's Heidemann. Vandersloot defending. Pass to January. From the wing. And no good. The Sky go the other way with it. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. A nice shot by Vandersloot.
When Vandersloot gets a full head of steam, she's tough to contain. Don't let her catch you out of position defensively.
Now here's January. Defense right on her. There's the ball off quick. That'll be her second foul of the game. Last quarter play, about 2 minutes in now. Stolen by the Shields.
Yeah, that was tunnel vision on that pass, focusing really only on the target and didn't see the defender.
Back to Quigley. Pass to Vandersloot. Quigley, covered by January. And she's good on the three ball.
When you look at the stats, the assist totals, they just jump out at you. They're way ahead of that category. Ball movement has been key.
It's just a different mindset.
Wind's going down quickly at both ends.
What an answer. Does that mean with the I'm coming right back.
Everybody gets
the WNBA has had single elimination playoff game since 2016. And the NBA followed suit, adopting a similar opening round format in 2021.
That's one thing the WNBA has done an outstanding job of, leading the way for basketball this country.
Absolutely, Tim. Lots of rule changes we first see in the WNBA. They'll end up getting adopted by the NBA and the college game. So you just got to give tons of credit to the WNBA. They're setting the tone for the rest of the basketball world.
Chicago in the lead.
2 minutes remaining.
She drives in. And she uses the glass on the layup.
Tonight is why, as a defense, you just try to prevent Quigley from getting into a rhythm.
January gets the ball.
Her throat has been dead off. Inside, outside, wherever. The shots are falling for her.
Here's Dolson. That comes off the assist by Colby Vandersloot.
No one is better than Vandersloot at recognizing and picking out open teammates. She has out of this world fortune.
Stolen by the Shields. Dolson shots good.
I love that the instant that steal was made, they were going the other way.
Ball pressure leading to the run out. Oh, yeah, I can dig that.
Oh, yeah, and it leads to an easy basket.
There's Heidemann. Pass to Jones. And there's the bucket. Staying with it that time. And offensive glass getting it done.
Brushing off the defense. This is why Jones is so loved in the locker room. She is so tough out there. Tough to guard. Just a great teammate.
There's the three. Drills it from outside.
She had her head on it. Beautiful. And was able to still pick up the pass and get the assist.
Vandersloot outside. Deep alley Quigley. Up and in. That's her 10th make in the contest. And she's only taken 13 shots to get there. And Connecticut has possession. 11-point game. Pass to Jones. January. No one near her. And again, it's
Connecticut. You have to respect the team game of January, and that can open things up from the this 15, 18-foot area.
Dolphins, shot's good. And they're not finished yet. They're going to make sure about this win.
Yeah, they're not taking any chances. This
Chicago
is how you close the game out.
Happy their coaches.
Third personal foul. Fourth team foul. In for the sky.
Pass to Heidemann. Inside. Here's Montgomery. Terrific assist.
Yeah, nice minute. Just a solid play all around.
Down there, the low post is where you want to create a lot of your offense.
And out of bounds, the Sun will take it.
Connecticut Sun ball. Chicago foul. Dana Evans. First personal foul.
She drops the first one. And that brings them within eight. So both teams making some changes here. Both good at the line. Side. Intercepted. Impossible for them to come back now.
Yeah, just too much work and not enough time.
Chicago so blows on the shot. That goes for the contact there. Vandersloot. She's picked up her final foul, and she will sit the rest of this one out. He had a comfy seat. That's it. And good on both. And so is Chicago with it. They've led by as many as 14 points.
First personal foul, teams first. Third team
and
foul.
So is Chicago with it. Leading by five. Thomas outside. Rebound Chicago.
Sometimes she can hit that deep three, but it's really not a great look for it. Not a very well-advised shot.
No.
First personal foul, teams first.
I mean, even for her, that's far out.
Shooting for Chicago.
So she goes 2 for 2 at the line.
Time
and it's a 7-point ball game.
2017 was a breakout year for Stephanie Dolson. She shot 56% from the field, 44% from three-point land, and average level 50 per game, making her second All-Star team.
In for the sky.
Goes up off the inbound, and it comes off the front of the rim. Off target with the shot. So it's Chicago picking up the win. They seem to relish their role as the villains here.
I sense that too. They really did feed off all the negative energy this crowd was directing at them. They turned it around and used it to motivate them to close out the win.
And that's a wrap, everyone.